While some people may appear to have a naturally good memory, there's a lot more nuance than simply labeling a person's memory as good or bad. Due to the incredible amount of information that we take in every day, an efficient system is required for us to exist, form memories, think logically, make connections, and a thousand other things we so naturally take for granted. The process of memory formation is therefore broken down into three steps: encoding, storage, and retrieval. Encoding occurs when we take in sensory input and change it into a form that the brain can handle. These three types of encoding are visual, acoustic, and semantic. These encoded pieces of information are then moved to our short-term memory, where they can last for 0 to 30 seconds, unless they are rehearsed or consolidated into long-term memory. The longer you actively hold a piece of short-term memory, the more resistant it becomes to competing stimuli or other factors that can simply wipe your slate clean. If information is deemed important or meaningful, then it will be shifted into our long-term memory. When a memory is initially formed, the hippocampus consolidates the information from that memory into a single idea, but over time, different parts of the brain link up with that neocortical region through molecular, cellular, and neuronal changes, making the memory accessible from various angles. Storage like this as a long-term memory can protect a memory for decades. Retrieval of memories is the final aspect. Depending on how the information is organized, either naturally or intentionally, it may be easy or quite difficult to retrieve. Long-term memory is best triggered through association, such as hearing a love song that takes you back to a crystal-clear memory you hadn't thought of in years. Some of the processes of remembering are within our control, and some are not. On the natural side of things, some people seem predisposed to having an incredible memory. One study found that people with such heightened episodic memory, a condition termed highly superior autobiographical memory, commonly called photographic memory, do have enlarged areas in the temporal and parietal lobes, both of which are linked to memory storage and retrieval. Genetically speaking, studies have found that certain genes affect the density of dopamine receptors in the brain. Dopamine is a neurotransmitter that helps us recall episodic memories from the past. There are many ways to improve your memory, thanks to neuroplasticity, the ability of the brain to adapt and change throughout our life. There are also plenty of other techniques and lifestyle changes that will keep your brain sharp. Challenging your brain with new activities forces the brain to create new neural pathways and form unique connections. These activities should be cumulative and rewarding, and are best when they're outside of your comfort zone, such as learning a new language or teaching yourself how to play an instrument. A healthy diet and regular exercise can ensure that your brain has all the nutrients and raw materials it needs to succeed, as well as a healthy flow of neurotransmitters and dopamine, which can help in those powers of recall. On a more intentional level, you should pay close attention to experiences and events, relate incoming information to memories you already have stored, and involve as many senses as possible when taking in new information. All of this can increase the likelihood of short-term memories moving to long-term memory storage. Understanding what you can do differently to boost your memory retention is the first step towards improvement. Consciously engaging and absorbing the world, rather than simply passing through it, can help your brain move information from sensory memory into short-term memory, and eventually into the long-term memory held deep and durably in our mind.